Well, guys, welcome back to the channel, Paladin Piper. So this is one that I had been wanting to try for a very long time, and that is Toscanello Aroma Anise, as I drop it. One thing I have to say about the little box here is I really like the tax stamp on it. Kind of old world. So these are cheroots. If you guys are unfamiliar with a cheroot, they are the kind of cigarillo that Clint Eastwood smoked in the Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, the Man with No Name trilogy. And a lot of those guys in the old westerns kind of smoked that stuff. Trying to get this off without like ripping the tax stamp too bad. They are made from Darkfired, Kentucky. And I'll read you the back here in just a second. I sure do package these things so nobody can get into them. There we go. Static electricity. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Look at that. There we go. The freshness of anise seed merged with the aroma of light Kentucky fire cured, a sweet combination of flavors. Strength, 1 out of 5. Taste, cooling and floral notes. Aroma, licorice. So there's a little closer pick of this tax stamp. So if you have been with me for a while, you know that I used to enjoy cigars. It was my main form of tobacco consumption for many, many years. However, for the past, gosh, when did I give up cigars? I mean, I might have had one on my channel, so 2015, I guess I had one. So 10 years approximately. I haven't had a cigar in 10 years. So this is a cheroot. Now, what's funny is, I thought I was gonna have to bite the end off. These are fermented, so they don't really need humidification. You get 5 in a box. There. Dry draw isn't bad. Definitely musty. Kind of got that dark fired, got that dark fired, pepperiness to them. Okay, so some spice lingers on the lips there. So there's a little sweetness. Definitely peppery spice. Musty. Garage note is not pleasant. Little sweet. Little like beef jerky. Not bad. I only smoked a few cheroots in my time. I enjoyed Churchill cigars primarily, and primarily Connecticut. Some Nicaraguan. But definitely spice up front on the tongue, on the lips. Little bit of anisette there. Well, it's good. So as I usually do, I will smoke this down to probably about halfway and come back to you with my thoughts on Toscanello, Aroma Anise. Stay with me. Well, guys, Welcome back to the halfway point of Toscanello Romananese. Right, I am a licorice file, okay? I love licorice in half and half. I love licorice in velvet. I love licorice in so many blends. Dark Strong Kentucky, which is kind of what I was hoping this would be, to be honest with you. Or like Dark Strong Kentucky, even though Curmudgeon Piper says that there is no licorice in it, there is licorice in that, and it is very good, well done in that. And the Dark Fire Kentucky in that is very well done. So I was kind of hoping that this might kind of fill that void for me, because I've got a lot of Dark Strong Kentucky in my cellar, but and not enough to last me forever, as they don't make it anymore. So but one thing, the pros of this, it has these hints of incense mustiness that a Latakia, yes, I was saying the L word, has in some of those blends that I love, and that's just kind of fleeting in this, which is very nice. Lots of spice. So my people who love Perique, and who love Dark Fire Kentucky will like this. Barbecue notes, like a barbecue roast kind of char note coming in and out. And then, and I'm going to say this, intruding on the party is the licorice, is the anisette. It does not play well with this. And I hate that. I hate that. Now, I am coming off of having a cold, and you might be able to hear that I'm still got a little bit of something. It was the not COVID, not flu. But it just the anise does not, the anise does not play well with this fermented cigar. I am, yes, I'm going to say it. I was wishing it wasn't in this. But that being said, and it gets really warm toward the end here. It's a nice little cheroot. Will I smoke through them? Maybe. Maybe. They may go in a giveaway. I don't know. I don't love it. I kind of just wish I would have gotten just the regular ones. But you know me, I'm a sucker for licorice. So, but there are some things that licorice should not go in, and that is this little cheroot. So, my rating for this cheroot without licorice, if I can detract my mind from it, I think it's a B. It's a nice little change of pace for a piper. With the licorice the way it is in this package, it's a D. Yeah, I may. I don't know. My buddy Hondo, he likes these little cheroots, and but he has not. I don't think he's had the one with anise in it, so he may like this. But the nice part about these is since they're fermented, you don't really have to keep them in a humidor or anything. They do fine in here. But yeah, so. Yeah, see, it was like this intrusive licorice that was trying to overpower a nice barbecue incense note. Right, guys, this will probably be the last cigar you see Paladin smoke for a very long time, but I thought I would do it, and appreciate you all joining me for the journey. And we will see you very again on another Paladin Piper video very soon. Take care, guys.